Welcome, race fans, to the Juicy Food Xfinity Series here. We are under the lights here at Kansas. Dalton on the pole here, but he'll be leading us down for the green flag, and there it is. Green flag is out. The round of eight has begun. And already off to a good start, Jesse Dalton in the TriStar machine there, already off to a good lead. There, as there you see the 19 of Robert Pollard on the inside of Spencer Gilmore. Car is already bouncing off the wall. Robbie Jackson spinning around. He saves it, but they crash behind them. Huge crash coming across the start finish line. They are still crashing. Dylan Schwalenberg's got a lot of damage to the front of his race car. The DeWalt machine already with issues there. Lily Gordon's got damage to the front end of her machine there. A couple of chasers. Eric Rodriguez has side damage. He's got a lot of damage. There's the caution is out for the very first time. Josh Ciculli looks like he might have gotten a piece of it as well. And they're going to be racing it back down towards the line. Dalton has a comfortable lead. And for them, that's really not really what some of those drivers really needed here on lap one of the race. Robbie Jackson was against the wall of turn 4, and then Keith Batson spun the 39 into the path of Kyle Matthews, and then a checkup behind them caused a chain reaction wreck with Kyle, Keith, Manuel Hartnett, Jeffrey Fingai. There's Eric Rodriguez got on two wheels there. And then the field trying to slow down. Dylan Schwalenberg gets turned. They all squeeze each other there into Luis Hernandez there, and then it's pretty sickly another chain of wrecks right there. And there you see Ciculli actually getting run over there in the back by Christian Master. There's Cody Lamas there in that wreck. A lot of cars with multiple amounts of damage there to their race cars, and this could knock a lot of them out of this race already. First retiree of the night goes to Dylan Schwalenberg. He will be out of the race early on, and a rough start for his championship hopes here already. Here at Kansas, Dalton continues to lead over Robert Pollard there and Spencer Gilmore. Back underway here at Kansas. The top four already running away from the top, from the fifth place car of Annie Thomas there. Randy Vanderhoopen looking underneath to the on the track there with the number 70 of James Qualls there. Dalton doing a good job maintaining his ground right now. Warren Keith now with a good run off of turn 4 there. He's going to look to the bottom of the racetrack there. Underneath Spencer Gilmore to the front stretch to start lap number 8 of the event there. And look at Randy Vanderpumpen. He wants to put a nose underneath the Chevy there of Warren Keith there. The 90 looking strong on that inside line. Look at the 70 car with a good run off of 2 there. Good exit for James Qualls there. Looks like the number 33 of Eli Bright trying to get himself some late ground here in the early stages of this race. Warren Keith smacks the wall for turn 4 there. That's going to bottle up the high side there. Gilmore and others. As there you see, they're still green. There's Eric Rodriguez and Lilia Gordon there in the 22 and 52. They're not running too well after that damage they received. There's Kyle Matthews running near the back half of the field there. He's not doing too well, neither is Joshua Ciculli. So if we get any more chasers having issues, this could really help Dylan Schwalenberg in gaining ground in the next two races if he can make it to the final four. Eli Bright now on the inside of James Qualls there for the all-important fourth position. Good move there, a bit of a slide jump maneuver there into turn 1. Luis Hernandez has a good head of steam off of turn 2. He's going to pass the 0-1 with much ease. Caution is out on the track, and it's Jonathan Zorlin and Emmanuel Hartnett that have collided in turn 1. They'll be racing it back down towards the line, and there's more contact. Spencer Gilmore spinning in the front stretch. He's around. He's got to hold on to it. Will anybody hit him? Spencer Gilmore in the middle of the front stretch there. That is very dangerous. And luckily, nobody slammed into that 0-1 there. Caution is out on the track here for the second time today. Jesse Dalton, now your race leader still. He's done a good job ever since he's gotten that pole. Looking at Jonathan, Zordon looks like he just had a flat tire coming into turn one, hit the wall in the front stretch, and then bounced into Matt McIntyre in the 62. Went for a spin into the outside wall there. Big contact there, not too bad, but watch Manuel Hartnett come into the picture here. He's just committed up high and bam, nowhere to go. Into the 62, big contact between the two of them, head-on collision, which sent the two of them dangling in turns 1 and 2 primarily. And then we're going to look at the second incident here with Spencer Gilmore coming across the line. They were racing it back down, and I think he hit the wall for turn 4. Yes, he did, and Rancho Cucamonga just had nowhere to go. But luckily, nobody else hit him. There should have been so many instances where the 01 could have gotten clobbered just like that. You just saw JT Bryant zoom on by. But luckily, Spencer Gilmore was able to keep on going. Robert Pollard now leads here, coming to the green. A couple cars stayed out, including him. We have different strategies on the track here. What will they do? If they want to get to victory lane, we'll find out here. Green flag, back in the air. Good restart for the number 19 there, Steve Pollard. Robert Pollard, excuse me. And Charles Sanford, though, already going to the bottom of the track. He wants to take the lead away just like that. Charles Sanford is definitely a contender you'll need to look out for in this playoff system. He's been one of the more consistent drivers on the track. He could be a potential threat for this championship here. Christian Master running in the second spot, started really far in the back, and now he's upwards in the field there, but here comes Dalton on the inside there. Luis Hernandez to follow in the 55. They're getting scattery all over the back. Stephen Paul the third way down the apron there. He's going to try and take it easy into turn one. He's on the apron, slides up the racetrack, and nobody hits him. Three wide action near the middle of the pack here. Annie Thomas on the bottom. Cucamonga there right in front of her. As Cucamonga able to try and gain some ground here on fresher tires. And the 19 bouncing off the wall. There goes Chris Dodd spinning around out of the front stretch. Kyle Matthews has damage. And they are still crashing across the front stretch. Huge crash all over the track. The back half of the field piling in. Kyle Matthews with a bunch of front end damage there. Lily Gordon's collected. Jeffrey Fingai's got a lot of smoke coming out of his car. And there's Stephen Pollard the third. He got swept up in it. Scott Roush was in it. They'll be racing it back down towards the line. It's rather calm now, side by side near the back. And Robert Pollard able to get that sixth position there, but Jesse Dalton back to the lead. He's not really cutting any slack in this race. They were all coming out of turn four. They were really close, bunched up together, really. And Chris Dodd bounced off of Steve Pollard, and then Christian Master Jr. hit that 15 there into the number 40 and the 88 there. Kyle Matthews, one of our contenders there, he had no place to go. Heavy front end damage there. Clips Alex May. They see Robbie Jackson and Seymour Butts colliding there. Jeffrey Fingai climbing up there. See Scott Roush on the brakes here. He's going to run into the 39 just a bit there. There's Matt McIntyre's damage. Drew Austin nowhere to go. Kyle Keith had no place to go. And then Lily Gordon at the end. Bam, no place to go for her. So already three of our championship contenders got swept up in it. I think Eric Rodriguez had a bit of side damage to his 22 car because of that wreck, but not as severe as Kyle Matthews especially. Matthews did not want to see this there, and he was running relatively spectacular compared to all the other runners here, and now his hopes are down the drain here today here at Kansas. He's got two more races to make ground up. We are reaching the halfway point of this race here. Jesse Dalton has really put on a show here, doing a fantastic job in car number 24. Teammate Charles Sanford in second, a championship contender there. Green flag back in the air. And Charles Sanford really slept on that restart there. Luis Hernandez was trying to attack there. Couldn't quite find a move there. You see those cars kind of scrubbing that turn one wall there. As into turn one, Sanford really defending the inside line there. Luis Hernandez hounding his rear bumper on that number eight there. Keon Eddington in the fourth spot. Here comes Charles Sanford on the inside. Couldn't quite make the move underneath Dalton quite yet. And Hernandez is now going to try and look on the bottom there. Good center off for the 55 there, And it looks like everybody else is going to try and follow Luis Hernandez. They want as many positions as they can if they want to get to that leader. But looking near the back half of the field here, we're just going to try and make sure there's not much calamity. Cody Llamas making it three wide underneath the 44, Kelly Bonston and teammate Eli Bright. But focusing back, Eddington really put the nose underneath the 55, loosened Hernandez up. And Sanford gets held up by Hernandez just a bit off of four. They're going to go three wide for position there. And Charles Sanford actually backs off from that spot. And there's the 19 of Robert Pollard. He's going to launch up way up high in the racetrack. Cucamonga is going to try and make it three wide. Hernandez way up the hill. Sanford nearly gets turned off a two. Keon Eddington now up to second. He's going to try and reel in Jesse Dalton here. Both cars have been looking very strong. Eddington has been a bit under the radar this season, and he hasn't had the runs to really back things up. But right now, car number 9 looking very good on the radar here. Very strong corner in turn 1. Looks a lot faster than Jesse Dalton, especially off the exits there. And there you see teammate Warren Keith in third. The Junior Motorsports car is running second and third. Cucamonga, the highest running contender right now, in fourth. Joshua Ciculli has been relatively quiet on the radio there. He hasn't really liked his race car though, but he's running in the mid-pack area. Running around the 18th position, so he's inside the top 20, but if he wants to get some more points, he's got to get as much positions as he can. Eddington right on the bumper now of Jesse Dalton. This 9 car has really found some good adjustments, and now he's looking lower on the racetrack. Couldn't quite get the run off of turn 4 there, and Dalton able to hold on. Christian Master right there in the 26, running inside the top 15, but kind of struggling with the car, starting in the back for a reason there. And car 26 really trying to find some late race ground here. And with some championship contenders out, such as Schwalenberg and Matthews, and a couple of others, that really could help them. Slow traffic in the way. Cucamonga is now going to get held up. Here comes Charles Sanford underneath Rancho Cucamonga for position there. And Chris Dodd trying to stay up high. And look at freaking James Quones there. He threaded the needle. He went way higher up the racetrack. Llamas now getting held up. Christian Master now getting held up as well. Here comes the rest of the cars trying to scramble around Chris Dodd. But Cody Llamas and the 26 are still getting held up by Chris Dodd. Certainly not of their liking. And Chris Dodd really not really doing anything wrong. He's just staying up high. There's not much room on the track. Warren Keith has gone around Keon Eddington for second. Rancho Cucamonga trying to fight back, trying to take back the top 5 spot here. That's for fourth. And a dive into turn 3 there. Trying to get a slide job, not really having to use much of that actually, and he's able to take it away quite easily. Marty Johnson has been quiet there. Look at James Qualls, he's trying to make it three wide again with Eli Bright. The 33 looking to make some aggressive moves here, trying to get some late track position again here. With the laps are winding down, time is running out. It's a 3-horse race. Warren Keith has taken the lead away, probably a pass out of turn 2. What a spectacular job for the 7 car. The top 3 really close together. Rancho Cucamonga and Charles Sanford are going to have to try and reel those 3 cars in. And so far he's doing so successfully, but we'll have to see where this ends up with within those final 11 laps. Hernandez on the bottom, 3 wide action in the back again. And Hernandez zooms on by. That's a power move on the inside there from the 55. Warren Keith now trying to run away from the top, the other 2 cars behind. Warren Keith looking very strong here. I think he's running better than Kyle Keith in terms of points. And Cucamonga now trying to get some ground again. Here, Charles Sanford not able to really capitalize here. And on the outside there, you see, look at the power move there from Robert Pollard off of turn 2. That's a really strong run for this 19 team. They really wanted a good run, and so far they're getting it. Dalton using the middle groove there to see if he can get a good exit off of turn 4 there. And looking at the intervals here, pay attention to car 3. He's reeling in a 10th per lap. So Cucamonga could get himself into the mix here. Lap traffic could also be a fundamental role in how this race will end up. Christian Master has really fallen off the radar here now, down to 20th on the grid. Really struggling with his race car there. Looks like it's fading in this run. Keon Engton really on the bumper of that 24 there. Junior Motorsports trying to get a 1-2 finish. Engton with an excellent run off of turn 2 there. Good exit off. Some acceleration really kicking into that Camaro. But Jesse Dalton really holding his line pretty well. Engton looking a lot lower on the racetrack there. Keith doing what he needs to do is just run the racetrack. And within 7 laps to go, this could be the 7's cars race to lose right now. Dalton has dominated a lot of the race, but Warren Keith has really capitalized on those cautions and adjustments that have really helped this 7 car in this run. However, they are coming up towards slower lap traffic. They are coming towards the slow JT Bryant. Rounding out turn 4, the top 3, and Cucamonga has really closed in on those 3 cars here. Let's see where JT Bryant will be encountered. And that's a terrible spot to really meet him. And that's gonna help Cucamonga a lot here, especially out of turn 2. Cucamonga has cleaned racetrack somewhat. And here comes Dalton on the inside to pass the 7. Cucamonga's gonna try and take third away from Warren Keith. And JT Bryant gets shoved up the track there. Engton now looking on the bottom. Good battle for the lead here. Within these final 5 laps, 5 laps to go here at Kansas. Engton on the bottom, Dalton up top, both of them side by side. Cucamonga now has taken third away, Warren Keith drops to 4th. Engton that still has that inside groove there, Dalton up high, Cucamonga dive bombs the corner down low. And Warren Keith looks like he's gonna try and follow, but he's gonna actually follow that 3 car. And Cucamonga now up to P2. Warren Keith now reeling him in. Cucamonga's the only chaser in this pack that has a shot at winning this race so far. Car number 3 trying to do what he can. He's got the run on the outside there, but Warren Keith's got his nose underneath. Couldn't quite get the nose down in 3. Engton doing all he can to hold off Rancho Cucamonga. They're coming towards Chris Don yet again. Where will they encounter the 15? It might be turn 1 again. It held Cucamonga up just a bit there. Dalton drives it really hard into turn 2. And he's going to lose a lot of ground there. I think we're going to have to count out that 24 this time. Dalton is going to have to wait another time to win. Cucamonga has only 3 laps to go to try and catch Keon Engton. He's surrounded by a Napa sandwich here of the 7 and the 9. Warren Keith, he's going to look to the bottom of the track there. He's looking underneath the 3 car for position. Keith slides up the track. That is just what Keon Engton needs. That might be the race deciding factor to prevent Cucamonga from winning this race. Warren Keith is going to try to do all he can to get as much points as he can to get to 2nd. And here they come. Keon Engton rounding out turn number 4. Passing Lily Gordon, not much of an issue there. White flag is out. One more lap to go here at Kansas. Keon Engton is trying to run away with this race. And with lap cars in the way, that is gonna really settle the score for the 9 car. Keon Engton has won in the Dominant Cup Series before, made in the chase, but did not last too long, got eliminated after the round of 16. But here he comes in the Xfinity Series, a rough season for him. Rounding out turn number 4, Keon Engton is a winner in the Dolman Cup Series. Congratulations to car number 9. Junior Motorsports gets a 1-2. The Napa cars doing a great job on the track. Jesse Dalton 3rd and Cucamonga faded to 4th at the end due to lap traffic. Charles Sanford, top 5 run for him. That's just what they really wanted to see here. The 8, Matt McIntyre, 6. James Qualls, quiet run for him in 7th. And then you got Robert Pollard 8th and Kelly Boston 9th. And last but not least, you got Eli Bright rounding out that top 10. Good run for car number 33. Your results first through 28th there, a relatively tame field after a calamitous race, or a chaotic race to be exact. It looks like the cursor doesn't work anymore. But what a job there to Keon Engington on the win here. 30 cars remain in the race, 27 on the lead lap. As we'll take a look at the point standings here right after this.